Information shared on the following program is for general information purposes only. It does not constitute legal, tax, investment, or other advice, nor is it intended to recommend any particular investments, products, or financial instruments. Always seek advice from your financial advisor, attorney, or accountant with regard to investment, legal, or tax questions.
Mr. Chambers, don't get on that ship! The rest of the book, To Serve Men, it's a cookbook!
No! 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 No!
Have a fear of flying? Well, just wait till you see how scary retirement can be.
Welcome to the only show in the country dedicated to helping savers worry less about money, The Worry-Free Retirement, with offices in Louisville, Bowling Green, and Lexington. Your host, five-time author and fiduciary, Tony Walker.
Two of the greatest fears we human beings face are, number one, the fear of flying, and number two, the fear of running out of money in retirement. As we'll see today, while both may appear to be non-related, one having to do with money, the other not, they actually deal with the same subject, and that is trusting our very lives or our life savings to others. Well, welcome to the Worry-Free Retirement, and you are about to watch the only show in the country whose words are specifically dedicated and tailored to savers, those hard-working folks who are more concerned with the return of their money than the return on it. Flying. Yes, I said it. Flying. The visual of all those poor souls waiting in a crowded terminal and then being called over a loudspeaker that nobody can hear or barely understand, begin to walk down that dark, dreary tunnel which leads to this huge jet, which nobody knows who's going to fly it. You hope two pilots who know what they're doing, hope they're sober and well-trained, of course, who are about to take you on a journey some 30,000 feet up in the air and hopefully fly you home safely to your destination. And while I have my own particular fears, flying is not one of them. Now, I do have two family members who are near and dear to me who have a true fear of flying, my wife Susan and my mom. In fact, I remember as a snotty-nosed 7-year-old kid, my mom and dad and Marty decided to fly out to San Francisco to see his sister who lived out there. Now, you would think in 1967 I would have thoroughly enjoyed a trip to San Francisco because included in that trip was a trip to Disneyland. But as my mom would like to say, for some reason, I don't remember this, but I decided to stay down at Granddad's house in Troy, Kentucky because I wanted to catch frogs. I kid you not. Anyway, my mom was so afraid of flying and was afraid that this plane would go down in flames that she took a separate plane from my brother, Marty, and my dad. Her thought was, I guess logically, if one of these planes goes down, at least Tony's going to have one of his parents to take care of him. Now, my wife, she will fly with me because we do a lot of flying, but she still admits to this day, Tony, I absolutely hate flying. Well, this fear that retirees have that we run into all the time is another huge fear, and that's them running out of money. Don't believe me? There's been a study done on this, and as you can see, the studies bear this out, that of all the financial fears people have, actually, government politicians is the biggest, but when it comes to money, their greatest fear is running out of money. Now, how do you overcome this fear of flying, and how do you overcome this fear of running out of money? Well, in my experience of helping all of these savers for the past 35 years do just that, I'm going to show you today how you'll never run out of money in retirement using products specifically designed to do just that. So what is it about flying in retirement? Why do people have such a fear of either? Well, the point of the show today is it's all about trust. Who can you trust to pilot your financial plane, or in the case of money, who can you trust to fly you home to safety and enjoy a worry-free retirement? So when we return, I'm going to show you why financial advisors and the financial world they work in, for good reason, quite frankly, are not the most trusting bunch, and how little training and knowledge many of these financial advisors have who are taking your life savings into their hands. You're watching the Worry-Free Retirement. You stay tuned. I'll be right back.
Worried about running out of money in retirement? For a limited time, five-time author and retirement specialist Tony Walker is making available his latest book, Mailbox Money for Life. For your free copy, simply log on to TonyWalkerFinancial.com.
In the movie Sully, Tom Hanks plays the part of a now legendary commercial pilot who in real life goes by the name of Captain Sullenberg, or Sully. Now, in this scene, immediately upon takeoff, Sully is dealing with the prospects of his airplane, loaded with passengers, having mechanical troubles, and soon having to possibly crash this plane into the Hudson Bay. Now, long story short, due to the Captain Sully's many years of flying experience and his ability to remain calm under pressure, he is able to successfully land this huge jet onto the water without a single casualty. Quite amazing indeed. So you put yourself in that plane. First, in the cockpit. Would you have any clue how to navigate that thing to safety? Well, of course not. Now, let's be much more realistic. Imagine you're the passenger in that plane, and all of a sudden you realize that plane is going down. What's your reaction? So, having an already fear of flying, you're on this plane going down. The question is, can you trust the pilot flying the plane, the only one on board, and hopefully the only one with the experience to know how to land this thing, to safety? Can you trust him? Hey, could be worse than boarding a plane piloted by Sully. You could jump into the plane piloted by young Jack Wallace. Take a look at this young fella. Now that would cause you to be very, very nervous. So whether it's trusting the controls of a plane to someone else or trusting the controls of your money to someone else, they're very much similar. We both have fears when we get into these financial cockpits of maybe rolling our 401ks over to the financial world or simply handing any of our money over to them. Either way, it's pretty scary stuff. So there's a lot of articles dealing with this. You don't have to distrust me. And that is that the financial profession, yes, I'm a member of this profession, is not well trusted among the general public. In fact, look at this article right here. This one is entitled How Schwab Ate Wall Street. Now, they're referring to Charles Schwab, which incidentally, as a fiduciary, I've got the decision I can pick any fiduciary custodian that I want to handle my client's money, and I've chosen Charles Schwab. In fact, as of the date of this recording, we have over $65 million of our client's money with 1,000 accounts to boot that is with Charles Schwab. Someone recently said, Tony, you know, I've been out talking to other advisors. I'm thinking about working with you, but these advisors keep saying all you all do over there is annuities. And that is nothing further from the truth. Again, back to trust. A lot of these advisors trying to talk about Tony Walker Financial, you can't trust them because they have no clue what we're doing. We use Charles Schwab as our custodian mainly for this reason. Look at this. Last year alone, this article says that Charles Schwab each and every day took in $624 million, more than its three biggest Wall Street rivals combined. Founded by Charles Schwab himself, I like Charles Schwab currently because they provide great service, they're totally transparent on their fees, and you can trust them to do what they say they're going to do, kind of like Tony Walker Financial. We're transparent with our fees, we're transparent with our commissions, and we provide very, very good service. This is why so many people trust their money with us. Here's another great article. You may have heard about this. Last year, Wells Fargo, look at this, nearly 70% more potentially fake accounts open than thought. Now, why would a company open up fake accounts? Well, that's because back during that time, nobody knew this. Many of their brokers were paid a commission on the number of accounts they opened, unbeknownst to what these consumers were doing. In fact, I guess they felt there was enough penalty that consumers were awarded $2.8 million because of all these fake accounts. Again, just adds fuel to the fire as to why people don't trust the financial industry. This is a good one. It's time for the financial services industry to regain consumer trust. Amen to that. Look at this. Financial services, it says, is the least trusted industry in the consumer's eyes, according to this recent survey. Folks, you know, I was even thinking about this. Of all of the advisors, if you will, in the financial world, the most trusted are actually certified public accountants, or CPAs. Now, when you think about this, this makes complete sense because they are, no pun intended, held accountable. You got to remember, a CPA does your taxes. They have to sign off on that tax return. Guess who gets to review that tax return for accuracy and also to make sure you're following the law? That's right, the IRS. So obviously, CPAs with this accountability built in are going to toe the line and keep things on the straight and narrow. I love CPAs. I've got a great CPA in Eddie, but it reminds me of a story I heard once of a man who was out in the middle of a field stuck in a hot air balloon he had landed. He was looking around, lost, and all of a sudden in the distance, he sees a man walking a small dog on a leash. He hollers out to the man and he says, "Sir, can you tell me where I am?" And the other man there walking the dog stops and says, "Well, of course I can. You're in the middle of a field in a hot air balloon." And the gentleman in the hot air balloon says, "You must be a CPA." The guy says, "Well, I am. How did you know?" And he said, "Because your information is totally accurate and totally useless." So when we're thinking about piloting planes, when we're thinking about trusting our money over to people, we got to think about the airline industry. What do they do to make sure that the Sullys of the world are going to safely fly that plane, hopefully, and get us home? Well, one thing they use is something called a flight simulator. Now, I've got a lot of clients as pilots, and we're recording this show in Louisville, Kentucky. A lot of these pilots have to train on flight simulators. Folks, they don't load people up in a plane and throw a rookie pilot up there and say, "Go get them, boy." No, they train those folks in different conditions, so hopefully when those conditions arrive or the environment changes, those pilots are aware of what to do. Well, when you think about it, the financial world does nothing like that. In fact, I could take any of you out there, assuming you've got a fairly average IQ, and I guarantee you we could pass the right tests in 6 to 12 months. I could have you out there on the streets calling yourself a financial advisor with no real training or anything, right? And this is scary stuff, and this is what I see in many cases. People have worked with, quote, financial advisors or money managers, but they are not working with what we call retirement specialists, which is what we do. A retirement specialist is someone who creates game plans. In fact, since 9/11, when I first started focusing on retirement planning, I have personally overseen 4,000 plus game plans, folks. I have personally seen in person, talked to people in person, over 10,000 people. So let's take an example of this. Let's say right now you're 63, maybe you're working for an employer and you were just offered a buyout. Maybe you're getting ready to retire. Maybe you even have an old 401k from a previous employer and you're just really not sure what to do. So your employer says to you, "Okay, Jane, you're getting ready to get terminated, but we're going to throw a little health insurance your way, going to give you a little severance. I know you were talking about retiring at 65, but I'm sorry, you're out the door." So they kind of walk you down the runway like you're going on the plane, and all of a sudden you are going to get on a new plane. It's called turning over your 401k to a financial advisor. And think about this. Think about all of the things you've got to decide now that you never had to decide before retirement. First of all, you got to decide, what are you going to do about that darn tax tumor? Do you take more money out of your 401k now because we're in some very low tax brackets, or you defer those taxes and wait to another day? What about Social Security? Are you going to take Social Security now, or are you going to delay Social Security? What about all that risk you've been enjoying with that 401k? The market's way up right now as of here we are at May 27th, 2019, but now you're retired. Are you going to continue to take a lot of risk with your 401k? What if that thing drops 40% like it did in 08? You're in deep problems, folks. Also, here's the final thing. You just went from maybe making six figures. Now you got to figure out how to make all of this work and make sure you don't run out of money and have to go back to work. Your spouse, you say, "I guess I could talk to them." You know, I meet with a lot of couples. Most spouses would say, "Hey, I don't know anything about this either." What about your employer? Can't you go talk to them? They're the ones that have been offering this 401k all these years. Can't they give you any advice? Nope, they're not able to give you advice. You could go on the internet. You could respond to dinner seminars. You could do all this stuff. Listen to radio shows. Listen to a guy in a sweater vest like me. But in the end, what you've got to decide is, who out there has the experience? Who's going to be your Sully that's going to be in the cockpit with you? And more importantly, listen, does that financial pilot have a co-pilot? And does that financial pilot have a crew of people that are making sure that this journey for you is going to be a safe one and get you home to safety as well and make it a worry-free retirement? Well, when we come back, I'm going to do something very interesting. I'm going to go through Tony Walker Financial, and we're going to imagine you're walking down that little chute there to get on our financial plane, and I'm going to show you how we're going to safely fly you and your money home and make it a worry-free retirement. I'm going to get the whiteboard out. I'll be right back. Have you recently retired, been laid off, or offered a buyout? Has a company you work for recently moved or been acquired or closed its doors forever? Then take advantage of this opportunity to move your 401k to safer territory. Why continue to risk your hard-earned money when you don't have to? Let's meet in person today to discuss your retirement options. Log on to TonyWalkerFinancial.com to schedule your no-obligation appointment to meet with me in person. Do it today. Welcome back to the Worry-Free Retirement. In case you're just now joining us, we're trying to make this comparison between trusting a pilot to pilot a real plane and trusting a financial advisor to pilot your money home, so to speak, and the problems many financial advisors have with those clients and, in turn, the lack of trust thereof. So here's what's happening. If you caught the previous segment, we're imagining a 63-year-old decides to retire unexpectedly. Everybody gets excited because now his or her 401k is available to be rolled over. The financial world loves 401k rollovers. And let me show you an example of how easy they try to make this sound. So a nice financial advisor or institution says, well, just roll that 401k over to us. And then their objective, of course, which is good on the surface, we're going to provide you income for the rest of your life. Now, a lot of people think, well, I've already gotten home. Isn't this what I do, Tony? I just roll it over and I'll say, folks, you haven't even left the tarmac. All you've done is boarded the plane. You haven't even begun the journey yet. There's taxes, fees, risk. Who's going to deal with all those things? Well, what we're going to do in order to really make this kind of related to flying, I've not got one whiteboard. We have two Tony Walker Financial Worry-Free Retirement whiteboards. And what I'm going to do is try to help you understand how Tony Walker Financial is fully equipped to produce for you a worry-free retirement. Now, let's talk about the cockpit. A lot of people say, well, is Tony the only person over there? I know he's been in business a long time, and I know he's done retirement planning for years. Yeah, I'm going to pilot the plane, and let's think about this. You know, as we watch the movie Sully, the co-pilot, I'm sure, is very well experienced, but it was Sully who was in charge of that plane and made sure that plane was going to be flown safely and was able to land it in the Hudson Bay. That's me. I have my pulse in my hand on all cases at Tony Walker Financial. Now, granted, our current co-pilot or other fiduciary in the office is Heather. She's been with me over 13 years and is very well trained. A lot of times, yeah, I'll pass the controls over to Heather. The key is, though, I don't leave the plane. You see, a lot of people, what they do, the financial world, they get you in, the financial advisor, maybe they were the original pilot, and you never see them again. And many of the co-pilots that they're turning the reins over to are not experienced in retirement planning. Very, very scary thought. Now, in addition, my favorite son-in-law, Trey, is being trained to be a co-pilot, but he's not even ready to co-pilot this ship yet. This is how important retirement planning is, folks. Once this thing gets in the air, the people handling your money need to know what they're doing. We say, well, Tony, is it just you and Heather piloting the plane? What about everything else? Well, that's the beauty of Tony Walker Financial. We also have a crew. You know, with any airline, it's not just about the pilot and the co-pilot. If there's not a well-grounded, well-educated crew that's attentive to detail, that plane is just as dangerous. You know, it reminds me years ago, and I never will forget this. For some reason, I remember I was in the Charlotte airport, and there was a layover. When there's a layover and they say there's having problems not due to weather, that makes you nervous because you're worried about the plane. Well, the terminal where we were going to take off from, they pull the plane up and they said we're going to be boarding shortly. And I look out there and on a ladder on the windshield is this overweight gentleman with a hammer banging on the windshield. I'm thinking, that's the plane we're going to get on? Yep, they boarded us on there. Pretty nerve-wracking. But basically, with any good crew, you have flight attendants. You have the people responsible for getting you on board. You have the people responsible for different navigational issues, those in the flight tower, and then still you have a pilot and co-pilot. That's the crew. You might even put mechanics in there or whatever, but here are the staff members, and not in any particular order. The flight attendants, that would be Rachel, okay, and Shanna. And you say, well, what do they do, Tony? They make sure all the service requests are taken care of. They make sure if you have a change of beneficiary, change of address, need to set up an appointment, need to change an appointment with me. They take care of all that. We answer our phone calls, folks. In fact, I always say there is no reason once you become a client of Tony Walker Financial that you should ever have to call a financial institution again. You call us. What about getting on board? How do you move a 401k or IRA over without penalties and taxes and all that? Well, we have Connie, who's been with me 15 years. She handles all of the 401k rollovers that involve annuities. And then we have Shannon, who handles all the 401k rollovers that involve our Charles Schwab platform. Folks, these people have made literally thousands of 401k rollovers. So whether it's a 401k, 403b, thrift savings account, lump sum pension, those folks will be assigned to move that money from your current custodian and get it on board to the Tony Walker Financial Airplane. What about navigational issues? Folks, one thing's certain, when we fly this plane, things are going to change. The environment is not going to stay the same, and we need to be prepared for that. Well, I've got Lisa, who assists in the navigation of the income plans. She is also certified in Social Security planning, can answer all those questions. And then I also have Leanne, who helps us with all of our tax strategies. So she makes sure that if we're going to do a Roth conversion or make sure where we're going to pull out your 70.5 distributions or a 72T, that we're doing things accurately. In fact, if you want us to, we don't take the place of your accountant. We'll be happy to coordinate our planning strategies with your accountant to make sure it's going to fit your situation. By the way, all of these folks work for you at no additional cost, none. We also have Trey that helps us currently, and Gina that helps us with all of our life insurance, long-term care, Medicare supplements, all of those planning strategies that go into protecting your money when you get into the second half of life. And then finally, you have myself and Heather, that's the five step of our process, remember we went over this, to monitor your progress and to make sure that if we do have to change directions a little bit, we're going to put that plane back on the same direction, and that's to get you home safely. So when we think about this, think about trust. Who can you trust with your money? And you have to remember that retirement is not a one-shot deal. This is for the rest of your life, and who you place your trust with is really, really important. Well, speaking of the rest of your life, you know, one day we've talked about tragedy, unfortunately, and what can happen in an airplane. Let's not go there, right? But the fact remains is we're not going to be here forever. So what does the Bible have to say about trusting Him in this life and then the life hereafter? Good stuff coming up, but I got to get me a cup of coffee. I'll be right back.
Tired of the roller coaster ride of the stock market? Let Tony Walker show you how to smooth out the ride with your money. Log on to TonyWalkerFinancial.com and let's get started.
You know, whether it's trusting me talking and speaking all these words on TV or trying to trust some other financial advisor, trust really does come down to words, what we say. And I love reading the words of Scripture, particularly with what Jesus had to say. You know, it's interesting. Jesus didn't try to flatter people. He didn't use His knowledge to try to talk people into giving Him money or sowing seeds like this fellow.
And you need to make a vow of faith of $1,000.
You know, we see things like this all the time, but case in point when it comes to trust and mixing the Word of Scripture, I had a lady come in the other day, and she mentioned to me all of her finances, and she said, oh, by the way, I got another $30,000. I don't think I'm going to see that money, though, so let's just not count that. And I said, what do you mean don't count it? What's the deal? And she said, well, to be honest, I turned over about $30,000 to a Christian fellow who puts on all kinds of concerts or events or something. Well, he was promising me 10% returns. Turns out he's being looked at by the SEC. So I asked her why, and that's why she did. She said, number one, because he promised returns, and number two, I thought he was a Christian. Well, Jesus, it's interesting, of all the words he spoke, the words of truth, the words of life, the words of death, the seven words that he shares in Scripture with his disciples are as follows. He simply said this to his faithful disciples when he sent them out in faith. Matthew 10:7 says these seven words were this: the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Now, why in the world would Jesus only share seven words with his disciples? Why were these seven words so very important to him? And why did he want his disciples sharing those seven words with everybody else? Because in them is all the truth that you and I need to know about life, money, and our ultimate fate. These seven powerful words will overcome any fear you have. I guarantee it. Because these words are something you can take hold of. And these words, these seven words, don't cost you a red cent. So whether you got millions of dollars or you're flat broke, think about and meditate what Jesus said. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Your ultimate destination is at hand, and that's in heaven. Well, what about you? Do you have a trusted advisor, one that truly knows the retirement planning field? Do they have thousands of hours of experience in the financial cockpit? Do they have a crew of people that are standing by waiting to assist you with the changes in retirement that will surely come your way? Well, I'm Tony Walker, owner of Tony Walker Financial, and when I created the Worry-Free Retirement some 15 years ago, I envisioned a planning process that would allow savers to use and enjoy, and more importantly, protect their money. So here's all you've got to do to learn more about the Worry-Free Retirement. Right now, just log on to TonyWalkerFinancial.com. When you get there, you're going to see this Let's Get Started button. And when you click on that button, that information will go to one of our flight attendants, as we like to call them, more than likely Rachel. Now, we're going to ask for some very, very specific information and send you what's called a starter kit. This information is highly confidential and will not be shared with anyone outside Tony Walker Financial. Once we receive your information, we will schedule a no-obligation appointment to meet with me in person at either our Bowling Green or our Louisville, Kentucky office. Incidentally, in Lexington, Kentucky, we're getting more and more feedback and folks wanting to meet with me. We are arranging times to come to Lexington to meet with people on an as-needed basis. So yes, we can help you over there in the Lexington area. So what are you waiting for? Log on to TonyWalkerFinancial.com and remember, there's no cost or obligation to meet. Incidentally, next week, a special guest will be in our studio, Mr. Tom Krause. Mr. Krause is an expert in the field of Medicaid planning. So if you or a loved one is facing a long-term care situation, a crisis situation, you're going to want to tune in next week for Mr. Krause. He'll be on for the full length of the show talking about something that's getting very worrisome for people, and that's the issues of going into nursing homes. Well, we hope you've enjoyed today's program. Remember, next week, between now and the time I see you, if all else fails, you promise me you'll be worry-free.